Welcome back, everybody, to Zerzera. Last time, we left off with the fireworks factory and also the shepherd's house here, which we are currently exploring. Not much else to show in this shepherd's house, to be honest. Just a bunch of stuff, a bunch of hay bales and stuff up here. And like I said, the idea is that you chuck the hay bales down to the sheep. And we have a bunch of different sheep down here. This is supposed to be like the shepherd's house. I think we used to have a Jeb sheep somewhere. There's a guy that got out somehow. There used to be a Jeb sheep here. I'm not sure what happened to him. Any of you guys named Jeb? Nope. Apparently not. That's bogus. Anyway, that's the shepherd's house right there. Kind of a cool build. I like the roof on this one. This is similar to a roof I saw Wells Knight build, so that's kind of cool. Let's see, over here, let's just go over this area. And by the way, all this empty space you see here, there's another sheep that got out. How the heck? all this empty space over here, you will eventually see buildings here. I just haven't gotten to them yet. Another sheep. Man, the sheep are getting out all over the place. Next thing we're going to go see is the teacher's house right over here. And of course, we have little farms along the way here. This is the teacher's house in here. So welcome to the teacher's house. Of course, there's a lot of books and stuff. We have, you know, like a little laptop thing here. We got some shelving here that apparently is no longer functioning properly. Here we have some apples, because, you know, teachers, apples, get it, you know? So that's that. On here we have the bathroom, pretty basic stuff, and then back to the main room here. And then upstairs we have a little bit of an attic area up here. Hasn't really been visited, you don't really go up here too much. There's not really a whole lot to see here. Yeah, the pistons, those will do that, but that's pretty much all there is to this, except for the balcony here. So that's kind of cool. A little bit of a teacher's house right there. And then we'll come on down here. Make our way along the road here. This leads us to the enchanter's house right here. And the idea is the enchanter is a little bit more of a wealthy guy. So, you know, he has sort of a bigger house. I really like... I don't know if you guys have seen this from the front. Let me just teleport over here. I really like the way this house looks from the front. The big window in front. Looks pretty awesome. It's like modern architecture, basically. So yeah, basically this one, yeah, you have a nice little riverside view, little deck out here. Coming here from the bottom, check this out. So, obviously, it's the enchanter's house, so he's going to have some stuff for enchanting. He has some enchanted books around. He's got an enchantment table. This enchantment table does work, by the way. So you see, if I do this, see, this should reset on the next one. Yeah, there we go. So this one controls these bookshelves. Actually, no, I'm sorry. This right here controls two bookshelves at a time. As you can see, all the way around. Like that. And then this one controls one bookshelf at a time, I think. Yeah, right here. So this is for lower level enchants. You want to use this one. Just like that. And then this one's for the higher level enchants. Sort of the idea. Although you can sort of mix and match them if you want to. So, I mean, they're not mutually exclusive here, as you can see. So, kind of a cool thing. Cool little mechanic there. And here we got the bathroom. Bathroom right here. Pretty basic bathroom. Enchantment table, of course, because it's the enchanter's house. Right here we have the express route up to the... well, it was an express route at one point. Does this not... shoot me up anymore? Oh, I'm getting stuck here. Okay, I see. I gotta step back a little bit. Hang on. There we go. Express route, as I said, up to the bedroom. There we go. So yeah, this is the bedroom here. Double bed, books and bookshelves galore here, of course. And again, nice view outside to Zerzera. I'm gonna go ahead and sleep through the night here, by the way. But yeah, this is the enchanter's house. And yeah, of course, you can drop down here as well and then come back up. And that closes underneath of you. So kind of a cool little elevator type thing here. This is the main dining room here of the Enchanters. Enchanter's place. Of course, he has enchanted tools and stuff. And there's a cool spiral staircase down right here. Which was pretty fun. Pretty fun to build. So yeah, that's the Enchanter's house right there. Next up, we got the school. The school is a pretty big build. Of course, more farms here. This is sort of like the outside schoolyard right here. Just a little tiny thing here. And then we can go inside here I think school is about to start. I'm fairly certain. So you should hear the bell ring in a moment, and all these doors should open and then close as the periods progress. And here we have the principal's office right here. Principal's office, pretty nice. Of course, you got some seating and stuff. We have a fire suppression system, of course, in the ceiling. And, yep, class is now in session. For first period, you got to get there in time. Otherwise, the doors, all these doors, will close on you. As you'll see in a moment, they will all close. Yep, there we go. So first period is now in session right there. Of course, no fighting in the school. Each of these classrooms is themed classroom. So we have a potion brewing classroom right here. Got our whiteboards in here. These are maps, by the way. I'll show you where these maps are located in a moment. And we got some announcement. Pizza party this Thursday. School pictures in the gym tomorrow. Very nice, very nice. But yeah, potion class in here. Very cool, very cool. These don't say anything, I don't think. Nope, okay. Cool stuff. Let's see. Student's favorite reading list. Yeah, there's a lot of details. Steve, A Hero's Tale. How 1.7 changed the world. Ah, okay, cool. We have some lockers here. Some of these lockers have stuff in them, some of them don't. But these are supposed to be lockers and things like that. Can't actually access those minecarts, unfortunately, anymore. This, if you break this and flick this lever, all these potions in the dispensers will fire. There's a bunch of redstone in the ceiling that controls all that. I think we're about to come to second period as well, by the way. And here we have the bathroom. This is women's bathroom, men's bathroom. Done through banners, of course. Yeah, you got your toilet paper, you got your toilet seat cover and such in here. Nothing too major. Same with this, nothing really too major. What do we have in here? Enchanting classroom. And yeah, second period now is in session, so you'll see the doors to all the classrooms have opened. Here's crafting. Crafting room in here. Biology room right in here. We got some biology and plants and stuff, and of course, a greenhouse. Every biology classroom needs a greenhouse of some type. And of course, the banners and stuff match the walls. I think you guys can see that, though. So yeah, second period now in session. I think there's 7 or 8 periods in total, I'm pretty sure. Here's the cafeteria, by the way, in case you're wondering what this is. So you got your fresh fruits, you got your water, you got your melons, apples, stuff like that. We got some cooked fish and stuff. What else we got in here? Anything else? Yeah, fresh melon, bread, nothing in there. But this is the whole cafeteria area. We got some cake in here. I'm just going to go and eat some cake. Nom, nom, nom. What else we got? Nether studies room. Nether studies right here, obviously. And, of course, there are, like, stuff. There's little details and stuff all over the place, like these chests under the desk, the portal banner, stuff like that. I don't want to go too much into detail because could be here all day. Physics right here. So this is, like, redstone stuff. You know, simple demonstrations of redstone. Same thing with this right here. So yeah, physics class in session right here. And then of course we have the gym. Gym is through here. We got the Zerzera miners, I believe. Prospectors, my bad. Prospectors. I knew that. Oh, third period. Doors are opening. Yep, doors are opening. People are coming into the gym. And yeah, here we have basketball. So basketball here. Here we have the court, as you can see. Obviously it's a basketball court. There's the doors closing. So this is the possession arrow. Tells you who has possession of the ball. Obviously, that's something you have in basketball. We got the benches here. That's the buzzer. That's the buzzer for the game. And we have some basketballs here, I think. Yeah, basketball is right here. And so the way this works, you run up to these pressure plates, sort of at an angle. Or at least you try to get it at an angle. Maybe. Maybe it doesn't work anymore. Let's try it. Nope, missed it. Let's try it again. There we go. Up, and then you shoot. He scores, and the lights light up if you score. So that's cool. We have the scoreboard up there. Yeah, obviously, there are prospectors. And then you take this out, and the lights turn off. So that's kind of cool. Kind of a cool thing. So you sort of, you know, can sort of play some basketball like that in the gym. So that's what we got there. Perfect. apparently that's also a basketball, square basketball. Who knew? Down here we have the concession stand. What's this called? Lucky Luke's. Lucky Luke's concession stand. We got Potion of Court Vision, Gatorade Rain, watered down Gatorade, high quality H2O, high quality water, and then regular water over here. So yeah, that's kind of cool. And also, does this thing work? This thing might work. Oh yeah, it does. All right, we got some zombie meat in there. That's cool. But yeah, we have a little fridge there. So, cool. Nice. It looks like we have another class going on. And now it's in session. Cool. So that's the school. A lot of redstone in this one. I think this is the emergency exit. Or it might not be the emergency. Oh, no, this is just for show. Basically, these doors here, these are the emergency doors. So if I... Let me just show you, actually. It's easier to show you guys. If I break this, let me see if I have a silk touch pick. Oh, I do. Sweet. Okay. So if I break this... So this is only in case of a fire, but these doors are emergency doors and will only open if I flick this lever. Yeah, you saw right there. So the doors are open and then they close. I'll just show you one more time. And yeah, the fire suppressant system working well. Awesome. And yeah, the doors here open. And the alarm is sounding, obviously. So that's what that is. Also, there are other emergency doors in the gym. So the other set of doors in the gym over there, that one also opens. So yeah, a lot of functionality in this school. I put a lot of time and work into this one, which is cool. So that's the school. We are now out of school. No homework, guys. Hooray! So yeah, that's the school. Over here, we got the butcher's house. So we saw the butcher's shop last episode right there, where you could buy stuff with emeralds. This is the butcher's house. In here, walk in here. It's kind of a grand house, really. Got a little living room area right here. We got a kitchen right over here. And the kitchen, if there's stuff in the furnace, the corresponding lamp lights up. So if I put this in here, see the lamp lights up there. So this is the redstone thing for this build. We also have a little secret area back here where he illegally keeps cows. So yeah, this is... Keep it on the down low, guys. Don't tell anybody. But right there, he keeps cows illegally. Up here, we got the bedroom, and also this sort of, like, overlooks, the living room area. And here is the bedroom for the butcher. This is the butcher's armor, too, by the way. It's all blood-stained red. Butcher, it's a nasty job. Up here, we got the attic. Not much in the attic, just some different stuff and things up here. Beware of mad cows, yeah. Yeah, so that's all we got there. If we make our way through here, down around, and out, come out here, let's go to ZAMR, the cool breeze. Check that out. Looks like we got some golems over here. Yeah, we got some golems in here. Oh man, this is going to be... One sec, let me turn down the sound. It's going to be intense. Let me turn down a little bit like that. I think that's good. So ZAMR, the cool breeze, this is the radio station here. Looks like zombies have taken out one of these doors. But yeah, you can see some classic hits. Herm by Villager number 33, 44 times platinum. I'm sorry. Ghastly Ghoul by Villager number 4, 4 times platinum. Block God by Villager Rap Group, 20 times platinum. And Cat by C418, 12 times platinum. So this is where you can sort of record your stuff. The doors are all gone. What do you guys do? People are looting this place, apparently. But yeah, this is a recording studio. See, we got the microphones up here, so where you sit down and record. And you put down your beat here, so... There you go. There's your beat. There we go, and should repeat it back. There's our beat played back, so yeah. So you can play any beat. And it'll play it right back to you, which is kind of cool. So this is sort of like a mini recorder, basically, for the music station, so... Kind of cool. And yeah, basically how you use this. But I really like this whole mechanic. This was invented by Pi314159, by the way. This little recorder here. Kind of a cool thing. Plays back your own tune. Then over here we have a little recording studio as well. They're slamming the door. They're having an argument right now. But, yeah, basically this is another... This is sort of like a private recording studio, is the idea here. So, yeah, that's kind of cool. Of course, these villagers are in the way. We got to put more doors down here. And also, we should go sleep. Let's go sleep in the hotel, actually. We'll go straight up to the penthouse. Start off at the penthouse and work our way down, I guess. So this is the hotel lobby right here. Emerald Isle Hotel, obviously made of emeralds. Took quite a while to get those via villager trading. And there we go. We're at the penthouse. So this is the penthouse here of the Emerald Isle Hotel and Casino. Looking pretty nice out here, I gotta say. Needs more buildings, though, especially in the distance. But, yeah, this is the hotel. Just going to go ahead and sleep here for the moment. And as I said, this is the penthouse. This has the most features up here. So you got TV, you got second bed, you got whatever this does. You got furnaces, clock, painting, a light that you can turn on and off, anvils, furnaces, decorations, you got music disc players, etc. Just dump that in there. Now, as we make our way down, you'll see that the rooms get less and less fancy. So this is also a pretty fancy room up here. You got a double wide bed, TV, got a lamp, armor stand, etc. A lot of the amenities here. And if we keep on going down, we also have, you know, some other details here you can see for yourself. But yeah, as we keep going down, stuff will get less and less nice, basically. Some signs have Do Not Disturb on it. So this still has a TV in it, painting. And every room has an interior. And you can, you know, go up and down on the sides via these elevators here. But let's just get out here, let's say. And this is one of the lower rooms. And it just has, you know, the basic stuff. What up, guy? My bad, didn't know you were in here. Look away, avert your eyes, guys. Alright, let's check out this one here. Yeah, so this is just a basic room, essentially, right here. This is like one of the first floors, basically. But yeah, you get the idea about the general feel of the hotel. What up, guy? My bad. So yeah, that is the Emerald Isle Hotel and Casino. And yeah, we have a little lobby area down here. Obviously, you know, you can go up to any floor with this minecart elevator and then get off. So that's how you get up and down pretty quickly. And then over here we have a little casino thing. This is the redstone thing for this. Basically, you have a chance to win a diamond. And there I did not win a diamond. I won some sand. It's 1 out of 9 chance. There we go. I actually won. That's the first time I think I've ever won on one of these machines. So this one's iron, this one's diamond, this one's emerald. Yeah, I won cobblestone. Cobblestone again, yeah. So yeah, these machines are super small and super easy to do. This one's a gold one. Didn't win. Anyway, back in the back here of the Emerald Isle Hotel, we have a nice little pool area. Apparently there's a golem taking a dip right there. And somebody who's stuck in the towel rack with a lot of bread. I'm not going to ask questions of you guys. I'm just gonna accept that. Here we have a hot tub. Hot tub right here. This is where you can, you know, sit down, lay, relax by the pool, etc. Up here we have some diving boards. And then up here, this one actually works, this diving board right here. So if I hit this button, there you go. Got launched into the pool. So that's kind of cool. It's kind of cool. And then, of course, you know, you climb up here, do it all again. So that's kind of an awesome thing. So that is the pool of the Emerald Isle Hotel and Casino. This is the top of ZAMR, by the way. That's why this is the radio station. That's why there's all the antennas and stuff. Let's see. Over here, this is where the main population of villagers is, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed. Some of these guys do have armor, by the way. If you don't know, villagers can wear armor. You just can't see it. It doesn't render for some reason. I'm hoping that's one of the things that comes in 1.11. But we'll see. Here is the Enchanter's House. So we saw the Enchanter's Shop. We saw the Enchanter's Shop. This is the shop, Enchanter's Shop. We saw the Enchanter's House earlier, last episode. Or actually, was it this episode? I don't even know. But this is the shop, basically. Ethereal enchanting. And so we have, you know, a bunch of different deals for armor. These guys, this is a popular place. Very popular. They're all checking out the armor. Is this guy? That guy's not actually wearing armor. he's just trying it on, basically. He's just trying it on. He's not really wearing it. He's just standing in the slot there. Yeah, there we go. And so, yeah, you can order, you know, enchanted gear from here and enchanted books and stuff. So these are, what, tool enchantments, miscellaneous enchantments, and these are, looks like, armor enchantments. Yeah, armor enchantments. And the redstone thing for this build is that you step in here and this becomes a max level enchantment table. So pretty basic. But still kind of cool. And of course he has lapis and books and stuff back here. It's kind of cool. Kind of a cool area. Anyway, that is that. Let's check out this thing over here. This is the Fisherman's Hut. Dave the Fish Guy lives here. And yeah, you see we have a dispenser here. This outputs a fishing rod. You step on it. Then you just step right out here and cast your rod and go to town. Kabam! Easy money. So that, yeah, that's basically all there is here. Well, on the first floor, I should say, on the main floor. Yeah, we have some other stuff. We got Dave's Guide to Fishing. This is actual, you know, Guide to Fishing. If I right click it here, you can see some of the Guide to Fishing. You guys can stop and pause if you guys want to read this whole thing. But some good tips in there if you guys don't know the Minecraft mechanics for fishing. Here we have the weigh-in station right here for the fish. So if you catch a small fish, put it on there, it just registers that. If you catch a bigger fish, you see it went up right there temporarily. And yeah, basically this you can weigh your fish here. So the more items I throw on there, the higher it'll go. As you can see here, it keeps going up as I get more and more items on there. So it's an easy way to measure your fish, and you see, you know, it goes from decent catch all the way up to master angler if you get all of them. So kind of a cool little thing here. And then let's see, I think I also have a boat. Yeah, I have a boat dispenser here. So if I hit this and walk right out and get into my little boat and go fishing on the actual lake, which is kind of awesome. I like it. So we'll put this back here. There we are. And so yeah, that's the Fisherman's Hut. I really like this. This is one of my favorite builds, honestly. Like, it's so small, it doesn't look like much from it from the outside, but inside there's a lot of functionality that makes it really come alive, which is cool. That's what I like to see. Okay, so got that. Let's go to the movies, guys. Let's go to the movies. We'll go over this bridge. By the way, this is a little vineyard over here. If you couldn't tell, you can see the little grapes growing on the vines and stuff, which are just actually emerald ore. We'll go across this bridge, though. We got a cinema here. We're coming to side entrance here. Now playing Interstellar, coming soon Jurassic World. So they're running some old movies here. Death Becomes You, a film by M. Night Shyamalan, opening March 2016. I gotta update these movie posters. The Magician, opening September 26th. Skeletor in Paradise, opening November 20th. So these are like movie posters around here. Ghost Rider 4, it's going to be a hot one. Opening in theaters January 2016, yeah. See, these are really old. I have to update these for this year, basically. down here, we got some functionality, but it's not going to make much sense. Yeah, without me explaining it. So here is the actual movie theater right here. You see we got, you know, water buckets, we got moldy popcorn. We got regular popcorn in the item, in the seats and stuff. More popcorn, stuff like that. This is supposed to be like an interstellar or space-themed movie that's playing. Once I put a villager in here, I think there was one at one time, but I think he somehow died in here. But there's stuff that moves around in here via the pressure plates and stuff. So it's kind of like a live-action movie almost. And of course, you know, you can't have a movie theater without a projector. So if you look at that lamp, there's your projector, drops down from the ceiling. Pretty nice. And then it goes back into the ceiling. Kind of a cool little detail. But that's that. Over here we have something that can dim the lights. So you see all the lights on the floor are now on. But of course, for the movie, the technician that sits in here just flicks this lever. And the music plays and lights go off. So that's kind of cool. So that's what is in there. And of course, this is just a concession. We got cookies, popcorn, and in here we got pie and melons. Cool. And of course, we have, you know, Headless Horseman. Horseman head from Sleepy Hollow in here. Arc reactor. Little details that I like. You know how it is. So then we come out here. This is the main entrance right here. You see the show times and such. And there's a few more, you know, movie posters and stuff. The Matrix Reloaded again. Coming September 4th. That'd be awesome, man. I freaking love The Matrix, man. But let's see what else we got here. Let's go now. Let's go see this. This is another Ender Pearl dispenser. Right here. Again, tutorial is on the channel if you want to check that one out. Here we have a library. Apparently someone has been in here. This is kind of freaky, to be honest with you. We have a book return right here. You put a book in here. I'll just simulate this with an oak plank. Obviously, it returns it right there. You got some books in the book return, looks like. More book return. This is the front desk. We got this all separated by section. So we got science and tech section right here. We got fiction A to M right here. And let's see, we got classical books right here. Poetry down here. And I did have a few stories up here. I'm not sure if they're still around. They might still be here. Perhaps, but... And then we got the big stacks of books right here. So fantasy, nonfiction, etc. Quiet Signs, of course. And then this is like the outer reading patio, I guess you could say, of the library. So kind of a cool thing. I think we had books in here at one point. I think they might have despawned, though. They might have broken and despawned. But yeah, you can actually climb the stacks, too, which is kind of awesome. You come up here, just climb around stacks all day. You know how it is. So yeah, that's that. Let's see. We also have like a little patio area down here. And this just leads back into the library. Alright, it's getting dark. So let's go over to the Potion Master house. Right over here. This is the inside of this house here. I just want to sleep through the night here so I don't get bombarded with mobs. But this is the Potion Master house. This is a very simplistic house. There's no real functionality in here. There's just a lot of brewing stands everywhere. And yeah, some of the stuff to brew it up. So yeah, this is the brewer's house right here. Pretty basic house, just a little adobe house. Pretty basic, but it's kind of cool. Up here we have the windmill, of course, obviously. Giant windmill there, as you can see. The blade's a pretty good shape, I would say. Yeah, there's a better shot of it right there. So yeah. Windmill, let's go check that out. I want to have this eventually, like, grinding down flour somehow. But I gotta come up with a way to do it. Interior is not much to look at, really. Just basically a simple interior. A couple different layers to it. You know, you can look out. There's some good views from up here, gotta say. Right there's a good view. How about that? Look at that. Screenshot that one. Boom. Done. So that's that. And we come in this way. Go up to the next layer. Next layer is pretty similar. Right here. Another good view out of this section. And then that's pretty much it. I need to add some more stuff on the inside of this. If you guys have suggestions, do leave them in the comments section. And I will consider them. But like I said, I want to eventually get like some grain being processed in here or something. Maybe with, like, hoppers passing stuff back and forth. That'd be kind of cool. Alright, so let's see. Next stop is... Yeah, you can see the library right there. I'm going to close that door, though. Close that up. There we go. Let's go to the mayor's house, which is up here on this hill. So this is the mayor's house. Mayor of Zerzera. Which I guess is me. I'm not really sure. Yeah, we'll get to this stuff over here later on. Some of this stuff here. But let's check out the mayor's house here. So obviously, mayor's house gonna be kind of fancy. You know, he has a nice little breakfast bar back here, stoves, ovens, etc., and nice little open living room area with a nice view of the over the river. This is a great view, I gotta say. Up here, bedroom area, and two decks leading off of this place. So very nice, very prestigious. Very prestigious area, and same thing over here, another deck. Very cool. But, being the mayor, he is subject to certain pressures from opponents, And sometimes the pressure gets a little too close, which is why we are actually out of time. But which is why sometimes there's a panic room. And as you can see here, here is the panic room. So if I just step on this, the door closes behind me, and we are safe now. So this is where the mayor comes to hide, basically, in case something goes wrong. And there's some basic provisions in here, furnaces, just the basic necessities, really. And then once he wants to get out, step over the pressure plate again. Secret passageway opens right back up. Step over it again. And nothing ever happened. Dun dun dun. So that's kind of cool. Anyways, guys, I am out of time, so we will continue the tour of Zerzera next time. We're almost done with this Zerzera city. And then we'll be getting on to some other stuff like the giant creeper, the space station, the guardian farm, witch farm, etc. Things like that. So, until next time, guys, thanks so much for watching. This has been Cub. Goodbye.